Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you the cool features you can do with our PandwaRF. For this demonstration I need my PandwaRF, the application for PandwaRF, and one remote. So when I launch the application, I have a few tips who are displayed on the screen, which are really interesting. I really recommend you to read them. Then I can connect to my PandwaRF, which is this one in the list. When you are connected, you have all the basic informations of your PandwaRF, including the MAC address and the battery level. So now I'm going to show you the RX text fragment, which is really important. So you have to choose first of all the frequency of your emitting signal, which is from this remote in my case. And you have to choose the data rates. If you don't know it, no worries, you can just measure it like this. You wait the green light to be on, and then you press the button. So now the data rate is measured. You can now just sniff the signal. So the green light is still on, so the PandwaRF is listening. You just press the button and the signal is red, as you can see here. You can also re-emit the signal. As the red light shows, the signal had been re-emitted. So now I'm going to show you the SPECAN analyzer, which is really useful if you don't know the frequency. So you have to check all the thing you want to appear on the graph. So in our case, we only want the RSSI, so we just uncheck these boxes. We start the measure and we can see the highest peak is around 433.9 megahertz. So this is really useful. So now I'm going to show you the brute force tab, which is really useful. So all our development team just have implemented a few functionalities and a few devices in the application, but you can also add yourself. We will show you how to do it in another video. So for example, we want a home alarm, we just select home alarm, the brand 4Cam, the model 1, and the function arm, for example. So the development team just did everything on the application, and then we can perform the brute force attack. As the red light shows, the PandwaRF is emitting. You can also compare the estimated duration between a PandwaRF, which is around 30 minutes, and a rogue PandwaRF, which is only 3 minutes. So there are more information about this online on another video which is normally displayed on your screen. And by the way, you can check the ATX status there on the little bar, which is progressing according to the emission of the PandwaRF. So thank you for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and goodbye.